Module 6, Part 3. Configure data permissions. Hello, I'm Peter Myers, and in this demonstration, I will explore two data permission scenarios, first by creating a dynamic role, and then by developing a data-driven design. Here I am in Power BI Desktop, ready to create a dynamic role. So I go ahead and on the left, I switch to the model view. And this gives me an understanding of the model diagram in terms of tables and relationships. And I notice specifically the relationships between the region, state, and sales tables. Notice the direction of filter propagation, the arrow pointing from region to state and from state to sales. That means that filters applied to the region table propagate to filter the state table, and in turn the state table filters filter to propagate sales. When a filter is applied on the region table, therefore, it filters to the states of the region and in turn to the sales of the states. Now it's important to understand at Tailspin Toys that they have six regions that are defined geographically, grouping the 51 US states, which includes Washington DC. So the objective is to create a role that filters the region table. To do that, on the Home Ribbon tab, I click Manage Roles. And then in the Manage Roles window, I click Create to create a new role, and I'll name the role Region. Then in the Tables list, I click the ellipsis, and I apply a filter on the Region column of the Region table. Now the DAX expression that's automatically generated is filtering by a static value of Value. But I'm going to replace that to use the DAX function, which is username. This function returns a string value representing the value of the authenticated user. However, in Power BI embedding situations, the function actually returns a value determined by the app, as you'll soon see. I go ahead and click Save, and now I'm ready to test the role. So I switch on the left to Report View, and then on the Modeling Ribbon tab, I then click View As. Now, this allows me to check the other user. Now, what that does is it lets me enter the value that the username function will return. So I'm going to enter the value of Midwest. Then I check the region role. So what I'm asking is to apply effective permissions that will enforce the region role with the username function returning Midwest. I click OK. Now, notice the yellow banner across the top of the report page, indicating that the report is being filtered by the region role for Midwest. Now, I don't see any filter change, and that's because region isn't shown on the page yet. If I do open the drop-down list for Slicer, I will see there is only one region available. And if I then select the Sales Map tab, I can see data only for the states of the Midwest. All right, I'm satisfied that the role is doing its job, so I click Stop Viewing to remove those effective permissions. I'm now ready to save the Power BI Desktop file and republish it to the workspace. So on the Home Ribbon tab, I click Publish, and then I select the Sales Reports workspace, and then I confirm replacing to overwrite the existing report and dataset. I now switch to Visual Studio Code, and then I open the appsettings.json. There's a third section added called Current User, and it allows testing data permissions. In the region setting, then, I'm going to enter Midwest. I save and close the app settings file. Next, I expand the services folder and open the Power BI API services code. I now add some new logic to the get reports embedding data method, specifically here when it enumerates the data sets. This new logic creates an effective identity for the very first dataset. We can see that the username of the effective identity will use the region app setting, and it will map to the role named region. Then I scroll down, and where the generate token request method is used, I go in and I add some additional code that is going to pass in that effective identity object. Now I'm ready to test the app. So I save and close the file. Press F5 to run. And then in the app, I open up the sales analysis report. And here in the map visual, it can be seen that only the states of the Midwest have data. I close the web browser session, and I return to Visual Studio Code, and I stop running. In preparation for the next data permission scenario, I return to Power BI Desktop, and then on the Modeling Ribbon tab, I open up Manage Roles, and I delete the region role. And then I click Save. In this second data permission scenario, I'm now going to develop a data-driven design. So let me switch back to the model diagram, and then on the Home Ribbon tab, I'm going to get data from a text or CSV source. I have this CSV file named app user, so I go ahead and open it, and then I see a preview of the data. The file contains two columns describing region and username, so in effect it's a mapping of users and the regions to which they're assigned. I go ahead and click Transform Data because there's work to be done. Here in the Power Query Editor window then, the transformation that I will apply is to promote the row 1 values to become the column headers. I do that on the Home Ribbon tab by clicking Use First Row as Headers. Now let's take a moment to look at this data more closely. Notice rows 1 and 2 for Midwest. That tells us that there are two salespeople assigned to that one region. And then in the username column, notice that Ty Johnston on row 3 and also on row 8, this individual salesperson is assigned to two regions, specifically New England and Southwest. So the results of this query will be loaded to become what we call a bridging table in the model. A bridging table, as you will see, defines a many-to-many relationship, in this case between regions and app users. On the Home Ribbon tab, I click Close and Apply, and that adds that query as a new model table. Now that the table is added, I notice also that a relationship was automatically created. But I notice that the filter propagation isn't correct. See how the relationship from region to app user is pointing towards app user. We need it to go in the other direction so that a filter applied to app user will propagate to region, which will propagate to state, then to sales. So to edit the relationship, I simply double-click that relationship between app user and region. There are two changes that I'll make. In the cross-filter direction drop-down, I switch it to both directions. And then to ensure that the filter will be applied during row-level security scenarios, I check the checkbox to apply the security filter in both directions. I then click OK. Then notice in the relationship diagram that the arrow is pointing in both directions. What matters is that app user filters will propagate to the region table. Lastly, I hide this table. So in the table header, I click the eye icon, and I ensure that that table is not visible. The purpose of this table is for security design purposes, so it shouldn't be made visible to report users, including the Q&A experience. I'm now ready to create a dynamic role. So on the Home Ribbon tab, I click Manage Roles, and then I click Create to create a new role. This time, the name of the role will be App User, and I'll apply a filter on the App User table and specifically to the Username column. What will be passed to filter the Username column will be the Username function. And remember, this function will return a value that our app determines. I then click Save. Switching back to Report View, let's test this role. So clicking View As, and then I'm going to enter Ted Baker at tailspintoys.com and enforce the app user role. Let's see what the data looks like. In this scenario, Ted has permission only to see the states of Midwest. I'll view as again, and this time I will try Ty Johnston. And I can see that Ty, due to that many-to-many relationship, has the ability to see Southwest and New England. Okay, it seems to be working, so I click Stop Viewing. I set that the decomposition tree is in fact the default view. I save the Power BI desktop file, then on the Home Ribbon tab, I publish, and I overwrite the existing version in my sales reports workspace. Switching back to Visual Studio Code, I go ahead and open up the app settings. It's now because we're not using region as a setting, we're actually using the app user. So you can think of this as being the authenticated user of your app, and let's test it for Ty Johnston. I save and close the app settings. Remember, this is just for testing purposes. Then I go ahead and open up the Power BI service, and just a couple of changes need to be made here. For the effective identities object, it now uses the app user setting in the config, and it now uses a role named app user. So I make those changes and save, and then close. And now I'm ready to go ahead and test, so I press F5. Now viewing the app as Ty Johnston, who has permission to see two sales regions when I open up sales analysis, and then switch to the sales map, we can see that the app is correctly enforcing the permissions for this particular user.